As I was going through the internet, I came across an article that was talking about a man by the name of George Floyd. George Floyd from the United States of America. This man was murdered in cold blood by a police officer who was on duty. It doesn't matter what the man might have done. It doesn't matter whether the man was wrong or the man was right. I want to talk about the African continent tonight. As I was looking at the video of this man who was putting his knee on the neck of this man by the name of George Floyd, something struck my mind and I began to realize that in the African continent, the exact same thing that happened to the man by the name of George Floyd is happening to the African people day in and day out. In as much as we are still crying out for help and we are not dying, it doesn't mean that we are not in pain. So many African brothers and sisters are suffering in our time in the hands of greedy politicians, in the hands of corrupt politicians. And if I begin to picture what happened, I begin to take it to Africa and I'll begin to say there are some greedy politicians, some corrupt politicians in the African continent who have got their knees on the neck of the African child, and the African child is striving and crying out for help, but the greedy politicians do not care, because as long as it pleases them, they don't care whether somebody is suffering or somebody is not suffering. I'm talking about the other day I was talking about the two major problems that we have in Africa. The first one is being the greedy politicians and the corrupt politicians, and the second one being the false prophets, the false teachers and the false pastors. If you look at what is happening in the body of Christ, you will see that we have got some prophets and pastors who have got their knees on the neck of the African child. In as much as the African child is crying out for help, you realize that the pastor does not care. As long as you are giving money and as long as you are putting money on the altar, he doesn't care. The knee continues to be on the neck. There is a knee that is resting on the neck of an African child, and that knee must be addressed in our time. There is something that I was looking at. The more I kept on analyzing this video, my heart was breaking so much, and I began to realize that until when is Africa going to be colonized? Until when is Africa going to remain a colony? Because we thought that after we gained independence, then everything is done and everything is solved. But after we gained independence, here comes the greedy politician to come and recolonize the African child. After we have gained independence, here comes the greedy and the corrupt prophet, the greedy and the corrupt pastor who is buying a private jet at the expense of the poor masses. Here comes a greedy prophet and a greedy man of God who is buying a Lamborghini at the expense of the, oh my God, at the expense of the poor masses. And you see the African child celebrating. Wake up, African child. There is a knee that is resting on your neck. There is a knee that is resting on your neck. Until when? The Chinese are slowly but surely coming to Africa. I came across some videos the other day on the internet. I saw the Chinese are slowly but surely taking over the African continent. The knee is coming to the neck. Slowly but surely, we are dying. We are dying. There is a knee that is resting on our neck. Enough of Africa suffering. Oh my God. Enough of Africa suffering. Enough of the African child suffering. There is a knee that is resting on the neck of an African child. And there is a, oh my God, there is a knee that is resting there. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Father. As I begin to look at this, you realize that oh my God. As the African child is busy shouting, "I receive," in church, the Chinese, they are busy invading the factories, invading the industries. As the African child is busy shouting, "I receive," in the temple, shouting, "I receive," in the synagogue, shouting, "I receive," day in and day out. Slowly but surely, the Chinese are taking over. Already in Zimbabwe, they have taken over. In Zambia, they are taking over. They are coming to take over Africa. Where is the African child? The African child is busy shouting in church. The African child is busy shouting, "I receive." What has happened to the African continent?